Hello everybody, welcome to the Python math section. In this video, I'm going to discuss the way to implement the Sieve of Eratosthenes. So this sieve is a method to find out the prime numbers that are below a given number, which is called n. The algorithm of the sieve is like this. We simply set up a list of integers that starts with 2, 3, 4, up to the given number n. Then we can set up some candidates to test whether a candidate can help regenerate some composite numbers. So the candidates can be 2, 3, 4 up to the integer part of the square root of n. And then I want to do the trial, which is equal to the square of the candidate number. While the trial number is not larger than the given number n, we do the if condition shown below. If the trial number is still in the list of the integers, we simply remove the trial number from the list. And then we leave the if statement and we simply update the trial number by increasing it with the candidate number. So the meaning of this process is to simply give me the next multiple of the candidate number to be tested. Now, let us see an example of the sieve of Eratosthenes. Suppose I want to find out the prime numbers that are below 50. So I set n to be 50, and then I set up a list that contains 2, 3, 4, up to 50. Now, let us see the case when the candidate becomes 2. So for this case, the trial number becomes the square of the candidate, which is equal to 4. And while the trial number is no larger than 50, we can do the if statement. If trial is in the list, we want to remove the trial numbers. So the trial numbers can be simply 4, 6, 8, 10, up to 50. So we can have so many even numbers starting with 4. And the further numbers of the trial numbers can be evaluated from the assignment statement following the if statement. Okay. So in this case, we just try to remove those trial numbers. And you can see that those trial numbers are already in orange color on the right hand side of the slide. Okay. So these numbers are to be removed. Now, the numbers removed by the previous step are in yellow, okay? And we try to test the next candidate, which is 3. And after setting up the candidate, I want to set up the trial number, which is equal to the square of the candidate. So I get trial to be 9. So I want to start with number 9 to do the removal of the composite numbers that are not regarded as prime numbers. And while the trial number is still smaller than or equal to 50, I do the if statement shown here. I want to remove the trial numbers that are updated according to the assignment statement outside the if statement. Okay. So the numbers to be removed can be 9, 12, 15, up to 48. Okay. But we have noticed something. 12, for example, is a number that has already been removed by the previous removal process. So we can see that some trials are already removed because they are already multiples of 2, and they have been already deleted when the candidate is equal to 2. So in this case, the numbers that are required to eliminate in this round are simply those in orange. Okay. Now, let us see the case when the candidate becomes 4. But we have to notice something in this case. The number 4 has already been deleted because it is already a multiple of a smaller prime number that has been already tested, which is 2 shown here, okay? So in this sense, all other multiples of 4 have already been deleted because they are also multiples of 2. So for this round, no additional deletion is needed when the candidate is equal to 4. Okay, we try another candidate, which is 5. So in this case, the trial number becomes 25, which is equal to the square of the candidate number. So while the trial number is still smaller than or equal to the value of n, which is 50, we do the if statement. So we want to eliminate 25, 30, up to 50. So by means of the assignment statement outside the if statement, we can see that the trial numbers to eliminate are these numbers. But of course, we have to notice something here. Some trials contained in this round are also multiples of 2 or 3. So for example, the value of 30 is a multiple of 2, and it is also a multiple of 3. So in this case, for these trial numbers, they have already been deleted when the candidate is equal to 2 or 3. So for this round, the numbers that are required to eliminate are only 25 and 35, and these two numbers are shown in orange. Now, let us see the case when the candidate becomes 6. So for 6, this number has already been deleted because it is a multiple of a smaller prime number, which can be 2 or 3. So you can see that number 6 is already in yellow. That means it has already been deleted. And it follows that all other multiples of 6 have already been deleted because they are also multiples of 2 or 3. So you can see that we don't need to do any further deletion for this round when the candidate becomes 6. How about the case when the candidate becomes 7? If the candidate number becomes 7, the trial number becomes 49. So when 49 is still not larger than 50, we can still remove 49 from the list. And for this round, we only have 49 to do the removal, because when we further increase the trial number by the candidate number, the number will be simply beyond 50, okay? So the number to be removed in this round is simply 49, which is shown in orange. We can ask a further question. Do we really need to check when the candidate is equal to 8? Actually, no. When we set up the candidate to be 8, it means that the trial number becomes 64, which is already larger than 50. So actually, the sieving process is not necessary to be processed when the candidate becomes 8. So in this case, we are pretty sure that all the prime numbers below 50 are found. And we can be sure that we just need to check up to the integer part of the square root of n. So for this case, when n equals 50, the integer component of the square root of n is simply 7. So we don't need to check up the case when the candidate becomes 8. And we can see that all the prime numbers are already in black color, and those in yellow are already deleted during the previous steps. Now, let us see the implementation. Because I want to make use of the square root, I need to import the math module first. And then I want to set up the number to do the sieving. Okay, I just accept a number from the input and then I turn it to an integer. So my idea is to find out the prime numbers that are below the largest number allowed. Okay, I just make use of the list comprehension to set up a list of integers starting from 2 to the largest number received from the user. Okay, the reason I need to include +1 is that I want to even include the largest number obtained from the input. If I ignore the +1 term here, I can never include the largest number obtained from the user. And then I can really do the for loop to test every single candidate. So this is the for loop. So I want to do the candidates starting with 2 up to the integer part of the square root of the input value. Since I want to include the integer part of the square root, I need to add 1 to the number so that I can actually include this number to be tested. And then I can continue the for loop. If the candidate is simply inside the numbers, I can do something like this. I can just do the squaring of the candidate to get the trial number. And the trial number is the number possibly to be removed from the list. While the trial number is smaller than or equal to the largest number, I can try to do the removal. Okay, if the trial number is still in the numbers list, I can simply remove that number from the list. And outside the if statement, I can simply update the trial number by adding it with the candidate number to be tested, so that I can simply find out the next multiple of the candidate number. And the reason why I need to do the if statement is that it is possible that a number might have already been deleted when we test the candidate, which is a smaller prime number than the one that the candidate is being tested. Okay, a number might have already been deleted as a multiple of some earlier prime numbers that have been already tested. So when we want to do the deletion of the trial number, it is possible that the trial number is not already inside the list. So in this case, I don't do the removal. I just remove the thing when the number is really inside the numbers list. And finally, I can simply print out the list. Okay, so that is the major idea of the program, so I can do the testing. I can try some smaller numbers, say 200. When I set 200, I can simply print out the prime numbers that are below 200. So you can see that there are so many numbers. And the principle is simply the sieving process mentioned in the beginning of the video. And we can try an even larger number. 1000. Okay, for 1000, we can see that the program is able to print out even more prime numbers. And since we only test the candidates up to the square root of n, we can expect that the candidates to do the testing will be only up to 30 something, which is the square root value of n. So we don't need to really check all the 1000 numbers for the prime numbers. We just check the first 30 something numbers in order to get the list of the prime numbers below 1000. So for this video, we have already discussed the ways to do the sieve of Eratosthenes. And we can see that the idea is quite simple when we can make use of some properties of prime numbers and multiples. This is the end of the video. If you have any questions about my video, please leave your questions on the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.